This is our main event of the evening. Scheduled for 10 rounds. Tommy Rainone against Robert Cannon. Tommy Rainone, whoops, forgot his mouthpiece. Pete Santiago quickly calls time. Little embarrassment for Tommy there. Whoops, remember the shoes and the trunks and the cup and the gloves. Forgot the mouthpiece. Tommy the southpaw and his opponent, Robert Cannon, out of St. Louis, Missouri. Robert Cannon with a record of 12-7-2 with 6 knockouts. Tommy Rainone, 18-5 with 4 knockouts. Tommy from nearby Plainview, New York. Tommy weighed in at 146.5. He said that has been his lightest weight in years. Cannon weighed in at 145. In Cannon's 12 victories, he's got 6 knockouts. Tommy Rainone, 4 knockouts in his 18 wins. I had a chance to talk to Tommy Rainone at length the other day. A very enjoyable young man, loves life. He's employed by a local hotel where he basically describes his job. He said, I love my job. I work late nights, do a lot of paperwork. But I do know this, as we talked about boxing, as much as he loves his job, he loves this sport. Because I asked him, what drives you in the sport? Why are you in it? It's the reason I'm in it. It's the reason so many of us are in it. We are addicted. And his addiction paid off to hard training and launching a great shot, which just dropped Cannon on the seat of his pants. And the question is, his eyes look cross. He is hurt. Let's see if Tommy can finish him. Tommy's big punch, the straight left hand. He's got a great left hand to the body. Let's see if he disdains body shots now and just continually goes for the head. These are 3-minute rounds. This is Tommy's fourth bout of the year, rather. He started in January with a 4-round decision win over Josh Williams. Then he lost an 8-round decision to Fitzgerald Johnson in New Jersey. And then he came back in August in North Carolina with a 6-round unanimous decision win. It's round number 2, scheduled 10-round bout for the IBA America's Welterweight Championship between localite Tommy Rainone and Robert Cannon. Cannon out of St. Louis, Missouri. Tommy Rainone out of Plainview, New York. Brought an army of fans with him tonight. Two of the cornermen of Tommy Rainone, longtime boxing associates of mine, Mike Carbone and Scott Lopek, two fine fighters in their own right about 10, 15 years ago. Looks like Cannon might have gotten hurt with a shot again. Tommy really knows how to relax in the ring. And right now, he doesn't look as relaxed as I've seen him, although he's letting his hands go, and he appears to be falling into that relaxed mode. Once he does, anybody's going to have a problem with Tommy Rainone. Try to load up on that left hand. He knows that if he gets the knockout tonight, it's going to come with that left hand. This is round number two. Robert Cannon was down in round number one from a straight left hand. Again, Cannon in the black trunks with the yellow trim, with a record of 12 wins against 7 losses. You could throw 2 draws in there as well. 6 wins have come by knockout. And Tommy Rainone, 18-5, with 4 knockouts. Again, this is a 10-round bout scheduled for 10 rounds for the IBA America's Welterweight Championship. Hard right hook. That one bothered Cannon. And another fine round for the lookalike, Tommy Rainone. Here we are, round number three. I'm Randy G at the Platowich Restaurant in Franklin Square, Long Island, New York, for Brawl in the Fall, brought to you by Ring Promotions. Your promoter, Bob Duffy. Our sponsors tonight, Westbury Jeep, Huntington Humidor, and Knockout Pest Control. Tommy just missed with that left hand, try to come back with another one. You could see now he's trying to measure Cannon for that knockout left hand. Tommy is finding a home for his punches. The face of Cannon is red, especially that left eye. There's that left hand to the body we were telling you about earlier. Tommy has one heck of a straight left to the body. Tommy is moving. He's always in shape, always in the gym. This is a guy who will train sometimes not once a day, but twice, even 3 times a day. That does not surprise me. Tommy loves to train. So what you're seeing him do now, he's moving, always turning, not giving Cannon any kind of shot at him. He bobs, weaves, ducks, slips, slides, walks away. That time in close, he ate a right hand. And he will have to pay for it. Like that. Many times when a fighter gets hit with a shot, he says to himself, okay, you got me there, but watch what I'm about to do to you in return. And you saw the 3-punch combination by Tommy in return. Right. from 1988 to 1995, one of the best moves I made was putting Melvina Lathan on as a judge.
Chelsea.
I brought her on as a judge, and a guy by the name of Wayne Kelly as a referee. Wayne only became one of the very, very best referees out there. Very unfortunately, we lost Wayne early this year to a massive stroke. Melvina Lathan became one of the best judges maybe ever. You know, in my mind, I make all these mind matches. It could be Sugar Ray Robinson against Sugar Ray Leonard. Melvina Lathan would have been one of the judges that I put in there. She now runs this commission and does one heck of a job. Has turned the New York State Athletic Commission in her few years as chairperson into one of the finest commissions in the country. And that's something it wasn't in the years following my departure in 1995, but that's a whole other story which you're just going to have to read in my book, my upcoming book, Glove Affair. Right now we're in round number four in a 10-round welterweight bout between Tommy Rainone and Robert Cannon. And this one is for the IBA America's Welterweight Championship. A little too much distance between them now, and Rainone knows that. He even said to Cannon, come on. Tommy still giving angles. There's that nice body shot, that straight left hand to the body. Right hook. Did not land solidly by Rainone, but it did land. The best of that exchange was a left hook to the body by Cannon. Cannon is a preservationist. He paws out with that left hand, pops that right hand, but basically tries to keep out of the way of any leather coming his way. It's round number five. I've got this a shutout so far. 40-36 for Tommy Rainone. You might be able to make a case for that last round, because Rainone looked a little bit frustrated. Not in his inability, but the fact that he's thinking that Cannon really doesn't want any part of him. And Tommy stopped throwing the punches that he's been throwing in the first three rounds. So if Cannon won any round, it was that last round, which I still gave to Rainone anyway. So I've got a 40-36. It could very well be 39-37. Solid right hook by Tommy Rainone. And one of his corner men just kind of mouthed the word, again. You know, you see a guy throw a hard shot, do it again. Especially when that hard shot lands. Tommy just walks away from the shot there. Sometimes Tommy can make it look so easy. Tommy raised both arms in close there to show referee Pete Santiago, hey, I'm not holding on. I'm not initiating this clinch.
7.
Don't give him this strap. Come on. Hands up, hands up. Watch your hands.
I am actually joined at ringside by Kevin E.T. Moley, former top contender back in the 80s here in New York, one of the most popular figures to come off Long Island. And Kevin, as long as you're here with me, you're going to have to just sit in for a little commentary. What does Tommy have to do here? I've got Tommy by a shutout, but it's a competitive shutout. Because Cannon, to me, is playing a little bit too much defense, and he's frustrating Tommy Rainone.
Okay, well, I wasn't paying attention too much to the fight, so I'm going to start to watch right now, and I'll give you my comment in 1 minute.
Okay, I've watched the first four rounds, and of course, Rainone, in the, what would you call those, leopard trunks or spotted trunks, whatever, and Robert Cannon in the black with yellow. Another round in the books. Got to give one more round to Tommy Rainone. Right now, we're in round number 6. Scheduled for 10 rounds, welterweight bout between Tommy Rainone and Robert Cannon. Robert Cannon out of St. Louis, Missouri, with a record of 12-7. Tommy Rainone, localite, Plainview, Long Island, with a record of 18-5. And these guys are welterweights fighting for something called the IBA Americas Welterweight Championship. A lot of media have turned out for this.
Hit him!
I do notice that one of the top photographers in the game, Peter Frutkoff, is in the house. And when Peter shows up, you know it's an event. And that's what this is, Brawl in the Fall at the Platowicz Restaurant in Franklin Square by one of the busiest promoters in the state of New York, Ring Promotions, Bob Duffy promoter. And again, our sponsors tonight, we want to thank all of them. Westbury Jeep, Huntington Humidor, and Knockout Pest Control. Now, I'm not sure if they knock out your next door neighbor if you find that they're a pest, but I think it just applies to insects and rodents. Here we are, round number 6. Welterweight bout. Tommy again tries that stiff left hand to the body. Cannon, a tough guy to hit with solid shots. You might hit him with one shot. You don't catch him with the combination. Robert Cannon trying to hunt Tommy Rainone down, trying to cut the ring off. Not having much success. Tommy's got a pair of great wheels, and you're just not going to walk him down. An army of fans here tonight from Plainview. Plainview about 15 miles from here. As referee Pete Santiago gets between them at the end of round. And it's round number 7. Scheduled for 10 rounds, welterweight bout. Tommy Rainone, Robert Cannon. Robert Cannon, the out-of-towner from St. Louis, Missouri. Robert in the black trunks with the yellow stars, yellow trim. We had an interesting card here tonight. The localites, Richard Neves, he won a decision. A majority decision was also won by Dario Sochi from Italy, now making his home in New York. Of course, Anthony Carparis, he is now 3-0 in a very exciting fight against Ray Velez. Michael Brooks took a majority decision 6 rounds in an outstanding fight against Brian Acaba. And Cindy Serrano took a shutout competitive fight 6 rounds over Angela Gladney. And then in a big upset, it was Nicholas Argyris, who in the local newspaper Newsday, there was a story on him, 5-1, 43 years old, 255 pounds. He took on 4-10 Corey Winfield, who makes his job as a full-time bouncer. And once in a while, Corey gets in the gym. Corey came in at 312 pounds and knocked out Argyris in the very first round. He's the kind of guy I would actually take over. He's got boxing ability. He's got power. He just needs time in the gym. And here we are. Round number 7, scheduled 10-rounder, welterweight bout for the IBA Americas Welterweight Championship between Tommy Rainone and Robert Cannon. Tommy Rainone trying to bait Cannon onto the end of a shot, but Cannon is not buying it, not walking after Tommy Rainone, taking his time, chasing him down, not wasting any energy. All the energy being used is by Rainone bouncing around the ring, trying to draw Cannon into a firefight, but not getting it. And I'm talking to Kevin E.T. Moley, who joins me here at ringside. Kevin, if you were in the corner of Robert Cannon, what do you tell him? What does this guy have to do to get into this fight?
Keep throwing more punches. He's walking towards the Acaba, but not throwing enough punches. He's got land punches. Throw punches and land punches. He's getting hit pillows right now. He needs to go in and use some harder punches and mix it up a little bit.
Here we are, round number 8, welterweight bout for the IBA Americas Welterweight Championship.
Let's go! Mix it up!
The crowd getting into it now.
Rainone, unleash! Unleash, Rainone!
Whoops, little shot to the side. Pete Santiago, I thought, may have some admonishment towards Cannon, but he didn't. Nice left uppercut to the body by Tommy Rainone, who may have gotten poked in the eye in that one. He grabbed his right eye. Now Pete Santiago calls them together and tells them to stop the rough stuff.
Come on, Rainone, show us what you got.
That's funny because up to this point, it really has not been a rough fight. It's been a fight with Tommy Rainone, has been using those marvelous legs of his, going side to side, in and out, up and down, trying to draw Robert Cannon in, but Cannon just will have no part of it and refuses to shift it into overdrive and just more or less walking after Rainone, takes a shot to the back, and again, Pete Santiago, no word of admonishment there. Nice right uppercut by Tommy Rainone. If we get a chance in the corner of Tommy Rainone, the biggest cut man in all of boxing is working tonight, Big George Mitchell, all 6 foot, 10.5 inches of him. And they once again fall into a clinch. Cannon falls short with a few jabs, falls short with a right hand. Tommy misses with that left hand, trying for that one punch knockout. He did get a knockdown in the first round, but since has not been able to drop Cannon, that shot may have gone a little bit low. Santiago has some words for him.
Robert Owens, be focused. Let's go, Rainone!
Tommy up and down.
Come on, Rainone, take him out.
Makes Cannon miss.
End the fight, you know, end the fight.
Come on, Rob.
Cannon smart on the inside. Knows how to tie Rainone up. And he does it again. Whoops. A little punch on the break. Tommy almost started to argue with the referee on that one. That wasn't going to get him anywhere. And round eight ends. Is cutman George Mitchell, a disciple of one of the best cutmen around, Al Gavin. George Mitchell, a retired New York City police officer.
By the way, I think his cuts or his eyes are from the headbutt. He's getting headbutted all night long.
Tim Moley just pointed out that Tommy Rainone has been getting headbutted. And you can see it, when they're in close like that and those heads aren't together, many times it just takes a little bit of a touch of the heads and one guy can come away with a cut. That was a nice left hand. Cannon shook his head no, but it was yes. No question about it.
I don't think he shook his head. I don't think he's shaking.
Here we are in round number nine. It has been like this all night long.
Tommy has some great moves, but he's not making him pay for it. Tommy has some great moves, he's making a miss, but he's not making him pay for it after he misses.
Very good point by Tim Moley. He said that Tommy's got some great moves, and he's making Cannon miss, but he's not making him pay for it. And there you just saw it. I mean, he stepped back, made a miss, and then he fell into a clinch. Tommy is almost like in preservation mode right now. Like he's got the decision in the bag, and he just wants to win that decision. Maybe he is a bit frustrated, because he tried earlier to turn it into a shootout, and by the second round, it was obvious that Cannon had not come to turn this into a shootout.
Rainone, go for the knockout! Come on, knock him out, Rainone!
The voice of Kevin E.T. Moley calling for Tommy Rainone to go for the knockout. Sometimes fighters just listen to their own corner. There we go. I think he listened to Kevin E.T. Moley. Now, was that a case of one guy having his foot stepped on? Whatever, because the referee called it a knockdown, it must be a knockdown. That will be a 10-8 round. Well, as I always point out, whenever you have a southpaw against a right-hander, you are going to have more headbutts than normal because their heads are just closer together. And you're going to have guys stepping on each other's feet all night long. Nobody did it better than one of the greatest of all time, Marvelous Marvin Hagler.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 10th and final round. Let's have a big hand for both boxers.
Here we are, 10th and final round. Now, let's see. Cannon's got to know that he's way behind. Let's see if he comes out and tries for that come-from-behind knockout. Let's see if Tommy tries for the knockout or if Tommy just sits back and goes for that decision, because this has been a rough fight. those marks on his face have not really come from the punches of Cannon, though. They've come more from the elbows and head. Frustration on the part of Tommy Rainone. He certainly didn't want to have to go 10 rounds tonight, and especially 10 rounds with a face that tonight and tomorrow is going to have ice all over. And if he has a cold beer, it's not going to be down the throat. He's going to be holding that ice mug against his face. We're going to try to get...
Tommy, it's up to you. Let's go.
We're
going
to try to get an interview with both fighters after this fight.
Take him out.
It has truly been a frustrating fight for Tommy. You can feel that frustration. But you wonder what Cannon is going to say about it. Because more than likely, this is going to be a shutout. Maybe he won one round in this fight. I don't think the judges will give him more than a round. Maybe. Two rounds. I don't see it, though. Ten seconds to go in the fight. A frustrated Tommy Rainone now wants to start a fight.
Hockey match is breaking out.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 10 well-fought rounds, the judges arrive at a unanimous decision.
No problem there.
Judge Forrester rolled down, scored about 100-88. Judge Rivera had it at 99-90. And Judge Tony Paolo scored about 99-89. All in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And now, IBA America's Welterweight Champion, Tommy!
Well, there we have it. The scores 100-88, 99-90, and 99-89. Again, my unofficial card, 99-90. In a very frustrating fight for the new IBA America's welterweight champion, Tommy Rainone. All the hugging, all the kissing. We got plenty of time for that right now. Tommy, congratulations tonight. The new IBA America's welterweight champion. It was a frustrating fight for you. Drop him early on, and then he never put his chin again there. He just grabbed, he butted you. Your face must hurt.
Well, yeah, actually, I got a headbutt late in the fight, and I just asked my friends if I was cut, and I wasn't, but my cut man told me that I was. Everybody put my eye, went directly my eye for about two rounds, and it never cleared up. So, you know, I'm fighting with my lead eye, my lefty. My lead eye was blurry the entire time, but you know, it was frustrating, but that's nobody's fault of my own. I should have got rid of him in the first round. Honestly, when I grabbed him, got a little over anxious. Then by the fourth round, I'm no moron. I started doing math in my head and saying I'm up.
Let's go back to that first round again. You had him down, you dropped him on the seat of his pants. Did you think right there it was over?
You'd be able to finish.
I thought I was going to be able to finish him. I got over anxious. Kept trying to land the body shots. Strayed low a couple of times, I will admit, you know. And he was tough. You know, he was a tough guy. You know, a little awkward.
I know you're going to play this fight over and over again in your mind. If you had to do it all over again, especially after that first round, what would you do different, if anything?
I wouldn't try and get rid of him in the first round, Randy, honestly. I really wouldn't. I'd probably try and, you know, step it up a little bit. I hurt him again in the second round, if you recall. And I stepped it up in the second round. Maybe I would have let my hands go a little more in the second round and gone to the body more, played a little smarter.
Right at the end of the fight, I could really see the frustration on your face. And at the very end, at that final bell, you threw another shot. And I said, now Tommy is trying to start a fight.
He kind of hit me once, so I gave him my mentality is to pay him right back, you know. So
okay, it's out of the way. What's next?
What's next? A little break. I'm actually leaving Montreal tomorrow with the postponement of the fight and everything. My whole schedule got messed up. But I'm leaving Montreal first thing in the morning. And then I'm about to be back by February, March.
Tommy Rainone with a big victory here tonight, a shutout victory. The new IBA America's Welterweight Championship. He's off on vacation. We're off. We're going to be seeing you back on December 13th right here at the Platowich Restaurant. We want to thank our sponsors tonight. Westbury Jeep, Huntington Humidor, and Knockout Pest Control. For Ring Promotions, I'm Randy G. Thanks for watching, everybody. Good night.